Hi guys, now today we will discuss about the product of the vectors. Alright, so actually product of the vectors. So basically there are two kind of product of the vectors. The first one is called scalar product or dot product, and the second one is called vector product or cross product. So the first one is called scalar product. Scalar or dot product of the vectors. Okay, and now the second one is called cross product. So we will discuss later after discussing about this scalar product. So basically what happens for the scalar, here I am just going to take two vectors. This one is vector A and this one is your vector B. Okay, so you are seeing that there are two vectors in a plane that makes an angle theta to each other. Okay, so simply here we have to take its product. So the scalar product of two vectors is purely a scalar quantity. Okay, so you can write down that the scalar product of the vectors B purely a scalar. That is, it is the product of the two vectors. It is the product of the magnitude of the two vectors and cosine of the angle between them. So now here I am just going to take two vectors. You are seeing here in this plane that vector A be there that makes an angle theta with another vector B. So what happens here, you want to find its scalar product. So scalar product is written by A dot B, vector A dot vector B. Okay, why? Because a scalar is represented by a dot. Okay, so in note you can put there in note that scalar product is represented by a dot. That's why it is also called dot product. Alright, so you have to take magnitude of vector A as per your definition, magnitude of vector B and cosine be the angle between the two vectors. So there is cos theta. Cos theta. Okay, so cos theta be there. Otherwise, You can also write down this one like A dot B or A scalar B is equal to AB cos theta. So this one is resultant. Okay. Alright. Now here we can represent this scalar product in rectangular component also. But before representing this in rectangular component, okay, first of all we should take its that which rules dot product we follows. Okay, otherwise we can see this one later on also. So first of all, scalar product in rectangular component. All right, okay. So accordingly, we have to take the same vector. Here I am just going to take vector A, and this one is your vector B. Otherwise, you just take like that, the three component be there. Alright, so this one is, suppose our vector be there. Vector A. So if vector A be there, and that is just going to be make an angle from the different component, that is from here x axis, from y axis, and from z axis. So suppose this one is x, this one is y, and this one is z. Okay. So the component of A along x axis be AX. I is unit vector. Alright. In same manner, component of A along y axis be AY, and its unit vector be J. Ultimately, along this z direction is AZ, and its unit vector K. Alright. And you suppose that this one is making an alpha. From here, this one is making an angle beta, and from this A making an angle gamma. Okay, so what happens from here? That similarly you can write down that vector A in its rectangular component be AXI plus AYJ plus A Z K. Okay, so this one is a rectangular component of vector A. Similarly, here I want to find the rectangular component of vector B. Okay, so similarly, rectangular component of vector B. Okay, so vector B can be written as in same manner, same be the diagram, but this one vector A be changed by vector A. So this can be written as BXI plus BYJ plus BZK. This one is your next equation. So what you have to do from here, that we have to take its scalar product. Okay, so therefore the scalar product product of the vectors A and B. Okay, so that would be simply this one is vector A dot vector B. All right, and now then we have to take its product. So, AXI plus AYJ plus AZK. All right, you can see here, and there is a dot product between BXI second vector plus BYJ and plus BZK. All right, so now here you are seeing that I and J and K, all these are perpendicular to each other. All right, here is also I, J, K, all these are perpendicular to each other. So those vectors which are perpendicular to each in its multiplication, that will be 0. Why 0? Because cos 90 is always 0. Because here we have to take the magnitude of vector A with magnitude of vector B, and there is cos theta. So if is there cos angle 90, so cos 90 is 0. That means your product, that will be 0. So you just need to keep it in mind, otherwise we will see in note. Okay, so you can see here that this one is your I, this one is your J, and this one is your K. Okay, so you just keep in mind this this equation, and then you see in note. See in note that this one is your x, this one is your y, and this one is your z axis. So along x your unit vector is I, along y your unit vector is j, and along z this one is k. So what you want? You want to make a scalar product between I and j. So the scalar product between I and j. All right. Yes. Between I and j. So how much be this? That means magnitude of I, magnitude of j, and cos theta. So between I and j, cos is how much? This one is 90. That means what? That this one is cos 90 is how much? This one is 0. So all factor this one is 0. All right, accordingly if you want to find JK, so scalar product of J and K, so this one is what? This one is magnitude of J, magnitude of K, and cos 90, again cos 90, so that is 0. Now you want to find KI, so a scalar product of K dot I. So in same manner you will get magnitude of K, magnitude of I, and cos 90, that is 0. That means the whole factor be 0. Similarly, if you wanted to find the scalar product between I and I, so how much be that? So see, scalar product between I and I. So how much be that? Magnitude of I, magnitude of I, and then cos 0. So cos 0 is 1, magnitude of I is 1, magnitude of I is 1. So product of 1, 1 and 1 be 1. Okay, similarly, scalar product of J and J. Okay, so how much be this? This one is again scalar product of J, magnitude of J, magnitude of J, and cos 0, so same 1, and scalar product of K and K, so magnitude of K again magnitude of k and cos 0, so remain 1. Alright, that means what? In a scalar product, the product of same the product of those vectors which are along parallel, actually all these vectors are parallel and these vectors are perpendicular, so those vectors are perpendicular be 0 in a scalar product and the vector are parallel to each other, its magnitude be 1 in parallel. Alright, so by this way we need to simplify this equation. So simply we need to multiply that a scalar product of A and B. B what? So see, I be there and I be there. So I, its magnitude be 1. That means you will get remaining AX, BX. Alright. So AX, BX. When you will multiply this one by this one. So here is I, here is J. So I, J, it's 0. So all factor be 0. Again, this one is multiplied by K, I, K. You can see here, I, K. This one is 0, so all factor be 0. Now, AJ, AYJ. When AYJ multiply by I, so see, when J multiply by I, this factor will be 0. Now, J multiply by J. See here, J multiply by J, so this factor be 1. That means you will get AY and BY. Now when J multiply by K, all factors be 0 because both are perpendicular. Same when K multiply by I, 0. K multiply by J, 0. And K multiply by K is 1. So remaining factor be A, G, B, Z. So A, G, B, Z. Finally, scalar product of A and B, that will be what? AX, BX plus AY, BY plus AZ, BZ. So this one is your resultant for a scalar product of two vectors in its rectangular component. Okay. Then now we need to see its properties. So some properties are there. Okay. So properties of scalar product of two vectors. So properties of vectors in scalar. So simply you can see here that number one, if vector A and scalar product, properties of vectors in scalar product. So what you are seeing that you have taken a scalar product A dot B. If you wanted to find the scalar product of BA, so these are equal because product will be same. Here is AB cos theta and here is BA cos theta. So ultimately AB cos theta be there also. That means both are same. That is product you will get the same result. So this property be called commutative law. What is this? This one is called commutative law. So this law be obeyed in scalar product. Now the second one is, if you wanted to write that A dot vector B plus C, and if someone write that A dot B plus A dot C. So you can see that both are the resultant of this one is equal to the resultant of this one. That means what? This one is true and this one is obeyed in scalar product, and this is called as distributive law. Okay, so this one is your distributive law. So that obey distributive law. All right.